Your Slinkily, written by me and only me. Kids love toys, but toys may hate kids for doing the funeral a bit earlier than usual. I'm one of them who feels bad seeing toys alive. When I was in 5th grade, I was gifted a slinky for scoring great marks. And guess what? Me and my sister pulled the slinky from each end so hard that the slinky suddenly slipped off my hand with a great force and hit on my sister's face. Lol, I laughed my head off. She started crying and complained to mom. My mom slapped me and threw away the slinky. At that time, my elder brother was in 11th grade, and when I narrated him the whole scenario, he was like, "Kutti, I too hate springs." Then I said, "Anna, I hate slinky, not..." "Hey, they both are kind of same, right? But why do you hate springs, Anna?" He said, "I hate them because it is in our physics syllabus and I feel a bit tough, Kutti." You'll hate springs even more when you'll take physics in 11th grade. Spring was just a toy according to me until I took physics in 11th grade. I felt the same as my brother told earlier. After reading Hooke's Law in physics, I was freaking out and went to cry out my anger to my brother. I said to him that, "Now sometimes I feel like keeping my head between a spring and compress it." "Just Hooke's Law, right? Why are you yelling at this simple thing, Kutti?" I was like, "Simple thing? Simple thing? Anna, when you were in 11th grade, you too used to hate springs, right? Did you forget everything?" Then he said, "No one explained me the topic as if I could understand, Kutti." It took time for me to understand myself. Now I am gonna teach you the way you can understand easily in a short time. "Wow, that's really great, Anna. Really lucky to get you as my brother." My brother took me to a toy shop and bought me a slinky. This one was metallic and was eye-catching. Also, he bought chewing gum, and as soon as he paid money, I grabbed one and started chewing then and there. Then my brother said, "There is no difference between you and a 5-year-old. We reached home and my brother went to the storeroom and grabbed some wooden slabs, nails and a hammer. He started to build something which was as clear as mud to me. I was keep on guessing what new invention he was making. Then he said randomly to me, "It's important to stress and strain a lot for your loved ones, Kutti." I was like, "Yes, Anna, for sure." Then I continued to gaze his creation. He just smiled and continued his work. At that time, I didn't know the reason behind his smile. After he completed, it looked something like this. I said him that it exactly looks like the diagram which was under Hooke's Law. Then as soon as I was to ask about the spring's absence, he grabbed the slinky and cut it to 3. I screamed at him, "Anna, why you cut my favorite slinky?" "Slinky? Your favorite slinky? When slinky became your favorite?" he asked shockingly. "Anna, it looked pretty, so, but this is really unfair." "Okay, Kutti, you don't worry. I'll gift you the same if you solve few sums based on Hooke's Law after my explanation," he said politely with his lovely voice. I was like, "Anna, you could have directly said that you are not gonna buy. Why indirectly giving sums and wasting your precious time?" Then he was like, "Shut your mouth and pass me the chewing gum." I gave him and he unwrapped it. I thought he would chew it, but He fixed one chewing gum at the end of the second cut slinky. Then he fixed two chewing gums at the end of third cut slinky. Chee Anna, what are you doing? Get aside. Let me chew them. Kutti, don't make me angry. I have sticked them as weights. I gave him an idea that why couldn't he use clay instead of chewing gum? Then he said, Kutti, I am not rich enough and if I use clay, I won't be able to get uniform marks. Each packet of chewing gum has the same mark, which makes easier for me to measure. And after the experiment, clay might be wasted. But in case of chewing gum, you might eat it, na? Then I yelled, Anna! He asked me what I understood from this setup. I said, the first slinky is in its normal shape. The second one has elongated due to the weight added to the spring. And the third spring has elongated more than the second spring due to the addition of extra weight. That's all now. He said, this is Hooke's law. You can see that as you increase mass, the length of the spring increases. Adding mass to the spring is nothing but a deforming force. So, we can say that force is directly proportional to the length but inversely proportional to the area of the spring. Therefore, force is equal to change in length. Now, if we multiply and divide this equation by volume, we get force is equal to volume by volume into change in length. And we know that volume is equal to area into length. So, instead of volume, we can substitute area into length in the second equation. Therefore, force is equal to area into length divided by area into length into change in length, which can also be written as force by area is equal to length by area into change in length by length. Since we know that force is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to the area of the spring, therefore equation 3 can be written as force by area is directly proportional to the change in length by length. Since we know that force by area is also known as stress and change in length by original length is known as longitudinal strain, therefore by substituting this in fourth equation, we get stress is directly proportional to strain. So, this is Hooke's law and I've proved you, Kutti. And stress is equal to K into strain, where K is the proportionality constant and is known as modulus of elasticity. Anna, now I understood clearly after getting the explanation from you, especially that proof part in which I was finding too much difficulty. So Anna, may I eat the chewing gum at least now? Then he went mad at me and started chasing. He taught me few sums based on the Hooke's law. He gave two new formulas for solving sums. He said that since you know that the stress given to deform the slinky is the deforming force and this led to the change in length of the slinky, therefore, Hooke's law mathematical form can be written as deforming force is equal to K, the proportionality constant, into the change in length. Also, for finding restoring force, the formula is restoring force is equal to minus of K, proportionality constant, into change in length. After understanding the formulas of Hooke's law, I did all the sums right. So, he took me to the gift shop and bought me a new metallic slinky. I hope this story made you understand Hooke's law and thanks for watching.